Hi, this is Dr. Pan recording from Tucson, Arizona. Hope life is treating you well on this beautiful Thursday afternoon, and thank you for watching this clip on Is this polynomial factorable? If so, and how? Okay, this is a really typical question because God forbids you want to go run through all the choices because 12 has 1, 12, 3, 4, and 2 and 6 as factorable, and so is this one. It's going to be a mess. So, of course, you want to know if this polynomial is factorable first, and if so, and then we're dealing with how to factor. So, let's take a look. If a polynomial can be factored, then this x equal to minus b plus minus b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a, this chunk has to be a perfect square because otherwise you won't be able to factor it. Okay, because when you factor, you have a nice round numbers, even if it's a fraction. So this one has to be a perfect square, so you don't have this nasty radical sign on. Now this is really clear because this is how else we can find the roots for that one. So let's take a look. B squared minus 4ac for our problem here is 28 squared minus 4 times 12 times 15, and this one is actually 8 squared or 64. Okay, so the answer is yes, we can factor it. Now once you convinced or do this checkup first, make sure it is indeed factorable, then we'll discuss how to do it. Okay, if you log on to my channel, there is a method called a triple play method that I teach my students, and it does help you quite a bit if you're not familiar with it, but I will go through it over here rather quickly, but I hope I can get the majority of the points in there. The problem with factoring this one is this darn coefficient is not one, make it really difficult. So this triple play method, you go on to the channel, it's Tucson Math Doc channel. You can look it up, just type it, search for it. Anyway, back over here. What we're going to do is we're going to trick the system. I'm going to draw a box here. I think of it as a magic box. Instead of factoring this nasty one, what we're going to do is factor a little bit simpler one where I'm going to multiply the coefficient onto this constant over here. Okay. Then I'm going to try to factor this one. It's still a unpleasant one to factor. However, it's not nearly as bad. The reason I'm keep on writing 15 times 12 is this. I don't want to multiply this thing out because it's a pretty big number. What I do want to do is take a look at what number breaks down and see if I can spot a combination of two numbers. When you multiply them, you get 15 times 12, but when you add them, I'm looking for 28. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to break down 15 into 3 times 5. I'm going to break this one down to 3 times 2 times 2. Okay, so basically, I'm putting them into the prime factors. Now, from here, I'm looking for a set of combinations, two numbers, anything you can combine such that when you add, you get 28. I'm not worried about multiplying because I kept it as the factored form. And what do you know over here? If you have 5 and 2 together, which is 10, okay, 3 times 3 times 2, which is 18. 10 plus 18, you got it. It's exactly 28. Okay, so I'm going to factor this one inside, which is x plus 10, x plus 28. Not 20, 18. My apology. Okay, now, like I said earlier, this is a magic box. What you do after the magic box is this. We still needed this 12x squared. So instead of writing the x, I'm going to replace it back with 12x. Okay, even though I started with 12x squared, and I'll show you how to get it back. It's ugly, 12. My apology. 12x. Okay, now. Smart viewer will figure it out. Wait a minute, 12x times 12x, that's not 12x squared. So what do? I'm going to divide it by 12. Okay, almost there. One more step. When this factor doesn't cancel either one of them, what you need to do is split it up again. This is how we're going to do it. I'm going to pull the 2 out, the first one. I have 6x plus 5. Okay. I'm going to pull the 6 out next to one, which is 2x plus 3. And as you can see, the reason I want to do that is because 6 times 2 is 12, and guess what? My coefficients gets canceled out. I'm left with a pretty nice and clean 6x plus 5, 2x plus 3. And there you are. Here's the factored form. Let's check our work. Okay, multiply it out. I have 12x squared plus 18x plus 10x plus 15. And what do you have? Exactly where we started. Isn't the math elegant and simple? Okay, math break. Okay, back to math. All right, so let's do a quick review. So the first thing is it factorable? It's a very good question. Check for it first. Using this determinant, b squared minus 4ac, if it is a perfect square, then the answer is yes, it is factorable. If the coefficient is not 1, you do use this thing called a triple play method. You can check it out on my channel. And then what you do is you multiply the coefficients. And when the coefficients is so big, you don't have to write everything down. Break it down and see if you can spot two numbers that will get you there. Once you spot it, rest the stuff. It's pretty easy. Okay? Don't forget to double check your work. All right? I hope this is clear. And once again, from Tucson, Arizona, this is Dr. Pan making learning math fun. At least trying to. If the video has been helpful, I would appreciate a comment or a thumb up. Until next time, have a confident day.